Hi, Sandy from lab401.com. Today I ask Talking Sasquatch, what's in your flipper zero?
The answer to that question is...
Guys, remember, context is important. Lab401's collaborators are professional pentesters. Techniques such as payload delivery, keylogging, and data interception are restricted or illegal activities outside the scope of an authorized penetration test or an audit. Only test against hardware you own. Or in a professional context, when specifically and contractually authorized to do so. Okay, back to the video.
Talking Sasquatch is one of the most exciting content creator and tools creator for Flipper Zero, and of course, a friend of lab401.com. So, what's in your Flipper Zero?
What's going on, you guys? It is the Talking Sasquatch, and recently Sandy from Lab401 reached out, asked me what's in my flipper. The answer to that question is everything. Now, everybody knows that Uber Guidos has the best repository when it comes to flipper files. Literally everything's there, from bad USB, sub gigahertz, GPIO diagrams, it's all there. But we all have that same stuff. But I've got a few things that he doesn't have. Specifically, I've been working with InfoSec Red on some really cool bad USB payloads, running things that nobody thought were possible. Specifically, I've got a keylogger that exports to Discord and a file grabber that will also do the same. The really important part about both of these scripts is that they are undetectable by Defender because everything is encoded in Base64. Furthermore, they're also both controlled by a command and control server, and there's also a remote kill switch. So if we decide that we want to kill all instances of these, we can do it. It will delete itself entirely and be gone forever. Obviously, I've also got the latest custom firmwares, including the RGB control. So now I actually have an RGB flipper as well. So check that guy out. Right now it's set to a color fade, so it switches from colors. It's super cool. This is literally my favorite mod of all time so far. Beyond that, I've got a huge collection of GPIO add-ons, including stuff that's not even available yet. Speaking of unreleased, check this out. This is from AWOC Dynamics. This is a dual ESP with a 2.8 inch TFT screen. It runs Marauder, just like Just Call Me Coco's ESP32 Marauder. This thing is so cool, check it out. So basically this runs a ESP that runs the screen, so it runs Marauder just like ESP32 Marauder from Just Call Me Coco, as well as there's one that hooks up directly to the flipper, so that can also run its own instance of Marauder and grab PCAPs on its own, plus you can dual boot Evil Portal with it, so you can run both of those effectively at the same time, just switching back and forth through another app. It is so cool. I've also got a bunch of CC1101, basically range extenders, big antenna, small antenna, cool cases, we got them all. NRF24, we got that. IR extenders, we got that. You want more LEDs, we got that. What about mag spoof? Well, we got two of those. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. Literally more and more stuff keeps coming out from the community every single day. It's hard to keep up on it, honestly. So I guess long story short, what's in my flipper? And it's anything I can get my hands on. It's great to be back here with Lab401. If you want to see more from me, check me out on YouTube. It's Talking Sasquatch. Back to you.
Thank you, Mr. Talking Sasquatch. I will ask more creators and security professionals what's in their Flipper Zero, so make sure to subscribe to this channel. If you want to figure in this series and tell me about what is in your Flipper Zero, please contact me directly. Lab401 is proud to be an official Flipper Zero distributor and the best shopping place for pentesters, ethical hackers, and law enforcement agencies. Always offering the best service and the best price. So be like Talking Sasquatch and shop at lab401.com. Take care and see you at the next video.